Are you a little intimidated by webhooks for automation? Webhooks are a great way for you to get two different programs talking together, but they're not exactly intuitive if it's your first time using one. Well, in this video, we're going to be breaking all of this down so that we can accept an incoming webhook to trigger an Airtable automation. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, and we made it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. In this video, we're going to be breaking down an incoming webhook. We're going to set this up from scratch inside of Airtable Automations. But before we get into that, if you're kind of new to automations, or if you just want a full fundamental refresher, check out my free training. I've put together this training so that you can start leveraging the power of automation and really understand the basic building blocks of automation from start to finish. So check out that training at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. You can sign up there for free and you will be well on your way to implementing more and more automation for your business and job. But let's hop into the heart of this video. We have got to talk about how we're going to build an incoming webhook to Airtable so that we can trigger an automation. So the first place to start is, why in the world would we use a webhook? It sounds complicated, and what exactly is a webhook? Well, my favorite analogy that I learned from Aaron Cronblit, hey Aaron, hope you're doing well, is that you can think of a webhook like a phone number. So the idea here is that you've got a secret phone number that's gonna connect two different things, and one of them is gonna call that number, and the other one's gonna pick up that phone number when it rings, and it's going to receive some information. So it's like a private communication channel that we can use between two different applications. So why would we ever do this? Well, sometimes we might want to build an automation inside of Airtable and it's not available. Let's say, for example, we said, hey, anytime something happens in Stripe, maybe an invoice is created, well, then we want that information to immediately pop up in our Airtable database. So if you were trying to build this automation in Airtable, you would come up to automations and you would look for a trigger, and the trigger is coming from Stripe. Well, if we search through the different Airtable triggers here, we're gonna see that Stripe is nowhere to be found. So does that mean we can't do it? Thankfully, no. All we have to do is a little bit of webhook magic to build that connection between Stripe and Airtable. Now, this presupposes that Stripe, or whatever application we want to get talking to Airtable, they have to have the ability to have webhooks inside of their software. So Airtable is able to receive the webhook information. We have to make sure that we can send it from the other tool. But thankfully, in our example, Stripe allows for that very thing, so we can go ahead and establish this webhook. Here on my screen, if I scroll down just a bit, you'll see that we have when webhook received. That is the trigger that we want to set up. And what we have here on the right, what Airtable gives us, is where we're going to have that phone call sent over to. So this is where we're going to plug in now to Stripe and say, hey, here's where I have the address or the phone number that you need to make that call to. And once you do, Airtable is going to immediately pick up that line and receive the information you just sent in. All of it is way easier than it sounds. So let's go ahead and copy this webhook URL. So we're going to need to send a test, but first we have to set up the other end of this. We've set up the receiving side in Airtable, but we also need to set up the sending side, or the part that actually calls from the other side of the equation, which in our example is Stripe. So let's pop on into Stripe here, and I've set up my account in test mode. So now that I'm here, let's go ahead and go over to our developers panel. And inside of here, we can access webhooks. We'll find that on the left-hand side. And this is where we can add an endpoint. So we'll go ahead and create that. And of course, you might be asked to make sure that you're properly signed into Stripe, because this is getting into the nitty-gritty of Stripe and we don't want to mess around with it if we're not having the right permissions. So ideally, you would be an account admin or someone that has access to these things inside of your Stripe account. Once in there, we can add the endpoint URL, and this is where we're pasting in that particular address that Airtable's provided for us. Remember, this is the phone number that Airtable's gonna pick up, and we're gonna make the call from Stripe. You can add a description here. This is really helpful if you have a lot of webhooks going on inside of your Stripe account, and this is gonna help you stay organized. Now, notice that you can listen to events on the account or listen to events on connected accounts as well. Below that, we see the different version that we're currently using. And here is the most important part, perhaps, is where we choose what events we want to listen to. Now, these are the events that will force us to make that phone call to Airtable. So when one of these events occurs, that's when we're going to go ahead and send that signal out. So let's choose the right event. You'll notice that Stripe has so many different options for us here. We have all kinds of different things that we can access and events inside of these things. So for reporting, for recipients, for quotes, all kinds of different things that we can establish and say, when this thing occurs, that's when I want to send this automation into motion in Airtable. So let's go ahead and access the invoice here. And inside of invoice, we can say all invoice events or invoice created, invoice deleted, etc., etc. Lots of different options. So for example, we could say, when an invoice is paid, pick up that webhook phone, go ahead and call Airtable. That's going to trigger the automation in Airtable to do a thing. So a lot of different stuff we can play with, but I want to do an invoice created. Here I make that selection, I add the event, and now that I'm done, I add my webhook endpoint. So now this exists and we are good to go. So now we have built the connection and we need to start and see, does it work? Well, let's test out and create an example invoice. Now, remember that we are in test mode, so anything we do here is not going to actually impact our Stripe account. So we can go over to payments here and scroll down to invoices and create an invoice. Let's go ahead and set this up. We can add a new customer and I'll go ahead and add myself just to make sure that I'm not spamming anybody here. So I'll go ahead and make sure that there's a customer in my name here with my email address. And if we wanted to fill out more information, we could. I'm good with this for now. Let's add that customer. That, of course, will not trigger the actual webhook. The webhook is being triggered by the creation of an invoice. So we now have the customer on the invoice. Cool. We can set up the payment date. So when is this going to be due? And of course, we don't have an item on the invoice. We definitely need this. So let's add a one-time product for consulting. As an example, this will be a $1,000 package, and we'll go ahead and save this up. So this invoice looks pretty good. $1,000 invoice sent to this person, and of course, I have all the right information showing up here. So let's go ahead and review the invoice. Looks good. Send the invoice to this particular fake client, and now it's out there. So what happens? Well, we should be able to go back into our Airtable base and now test this trigger. Let's go ahead and give it a test. And we'll see that, yes, in fact, we did receive some information from that Stripe integration. So now we can open up this webhook and look at the body that was received. So we see all of the information from that particular webhook. So we have the data that came in here in the object. We see the invoice, the country. Scrolling down, we see that the invoice was sent. It was sent to this customer. We should be able to find the amount of this invoice somewhere, maybe not because it's in test mode, but you get the idea. All of that information that we just sent over when we created that invoice was received by Airtable, and it's going to trigger the automation at the same time. So now we can do something like add an action and create a record inside of our Airtable base. But of course, at present, we don't have the information available for us because if we flip back into our data schema, we've got a blank table. Not very helpful. So let's add some information here, like who's the customer email? So I can set up the email address here. Boom, create that field. I can set up something like the invoice ID, use a single line text for this. We can set up the status of this particular invoice. So I can set up a single select field for this. So you get the idea. Lots of different information that we now have available to us from that Stripe webhook that was just sent over to Airtable, and we can now build out an automation from this. So let's flip back to that automation. Now that we have this, we're creating a record inside of our Stripe invoices table. We can go ahead and choose those new fields that we created, customer email. How do we access it? Again, we have to go into the webhook that was received, go into the body of that webhook, and if we search for it, we should be able to find email. So we can drill into data here, object. Let's try one more time. See if we got to the right place. There's the customer email. So great, we mapped out to the right place. So we've got that information somewhere in that body of information that was sent to us from the webhook, and we've now mapped that to our customer email. We can do it again for the ID. So go ahead and hit that plus, find the body here, and if I start looking for just ID, I can drill into the data, into the object, and there's the invoice ID. So this is a great way for you to start going step by step. There's a lot of information that comes in from these webhooks, especially from robust platforms like Stripe that have so much data. But there are so many different tools out there like Stripe that have the ability to create webhooks that can communicate with a direct integration like this through the webhook. So again, let's set up that status. And this particular webhook, I need to set it to be dynamic data. And once we've created a new invoice, there should be a status field here. So let's go ahead and look it up inside of data, inside of object. Scroll on down for that status. Where are you? Here we go. Currently in draft mode. So again, lots of different data. Scroll through that data, find what you need, and map it to the proper fields for you in Airtable. Once you're good there, go ahead and run that test. Let's go ahead and flip over now to our data schema just in time to see that we created that new invoice. So obviously I didn't fully bake this automation. I would want to include things like the amount and also track when it's due, when it's paid, all kinds of stuff. And we can do that with subsequent webhooks as well by setting up different webhooks that trigger off of different events. If you recall, we set it up so that this particular webhook was sent when we finalized an invoice. But on the other hand, we can say whenever a change is made to an invoice, whenever an invoice is paid, whenever a customer's information is updated. So this is going to give you a direct integration with those platforms that you didn't already have access to through the native tools. Because again, if you recall, we don't have a direct integration to Stripe, but webhook solved that for us. Hey, I know we went fast in this video. There's definitely a lot to cover here, and this can be an intimidating subject. So if you have any questions, drop them below and we will answer those as quickly as we can. And of course, if you haven't already, please consider subscribing to the channel so that you can stay up to date on no-code news just like this. In the meantime, I look forward to seeing you in the next video. As always, I hope you found this to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website to see how we can help. We offer an exclusive free training that teaches the fundamentals of no-code tools, including automation. We also have some paid services available, including advanced courses, no-code hourly consulting, as well as custom project consulting. So swing on by to get the help you need, and we look forward to connecting with you soon.